Hi guys, I want to talk about options and what happens after school. Mentioned or said, if you go to a mainstream school, even a mainstream school that caters for, and I say caters for very literally there, people with disabilities, early year 8, maybe year 9, you get given options. You get given the options to drop classes and maybe have one or two classes extra that isn't found in mainstream school. It's found after you've learnt so much about the main 9, 10, 11 subjects. But the options you have after school kind of affect what happens to you if you're disabled or not. If I had the chance, I am now 29, 30. If I could go back and say that I want to be a writer or a YouTuber or an editor, I would do, because I know now what it is I want to do, what it is I'm good at. I had no idea. When I left school, I had no idea that I wanted to do this. This probably wasn't around then. Maybe the writing was, but, you know, being able to write. You know, I'm dyslexic. And yeah, you have ghostwriters and proofreaders and who will do this for a living and they would have help to be able to do it. However, I don't know if I went back and I said, maybe if I said I wanted to be a writer and an editor and a filmmaker, then people may laugh at you. Or laugh at me. It's definitely a odd subject I would say it isn't taught at school, but it's not. I mean, media is. The arts are. Storytelling and story writing are. But it's not one of those typical jobs and typical careers that you kind of have and want. And when I grew up, I didn't know what I wanted to be, really. When the careers lady at my school said, you know, what do you want to do at the next step? It was kind of, well, what were your passions or interests? And I said, I wanted to be a gardener, because at the time, I was helping my grandfather with his. It's a very practical job. It's not a very practical decision to have as a young disabled man. So, yeah, I am going to put this out there. I am making this video for anyone who is thinking about going into year 9 and, I think it's year 9, and considering options and considering what they're going to do next. Because what they're going to do next will probably dictate the rest of their lives. It's true that things like the internet, things like YouTube, and Skillshare now, and very, very rarely other offline courses may turn up. But it's a lot easier if you go straight from school and you know what you want to do straight from school. Don't get me wrong, I went to college after school, again, for gardening, for horticulture and conservation. I did a bit of brick work. That was insane, and And then what care? And what care was great. I like that one care. Do I use any of the qualification that I got at school, at college? Maybe how to walk and look after a dog, which I have. That is probably it. That's, I know from quite possibly years of trying here that there are certain skill sets that I have that aren't necessary anymore. There are skill sets that I wish I had, so don't. Like YouTube, for example. I'm going to leave this one here, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.